So you could have a Mercedes-Benz S320 CDI that was only a year old, or you could have a Ferrari Testarossa and £10,000 change. Sorry, £6,000 change.
Hello, I am back at the same spot I was at yesterday with a much happier video today. Would you like to jump in my Alfa Romeo with me, have a cup of tea, and look at a Cars for Sale magazine from 2006 and laugh at the prices of things that we should have bought? Come on, let's go and have a nice time together, just you and me.
Well, the river has certainly come up a little bit since yesterday's video. My car yesterday was further back, and if my car was there now, we'd be in the water. So, today I have Great Cars magazine from 2006, and I have a cup of tea. So, after a run of slightly depressing Geoff videos, let's have a cup of tea and we'll have a little bit of a laugh about some car values, and I think we'll talk a bit about car values as well. Earlier on Instagram, I saw Giles, the classic car valuer, made a post about the fact that Jaguar E-Type values are down 25%, and asking why people think that E-Type values are down 25%. Well, owners of E-Types are probably down 25% as well, Giles. You know, if you're selling a product that is primarily only of interest to people of a certain age and they all die, well, then who's going to buy that product? Is there a big crash coming in the classic car market? No. Is there a realignment of values because certain cars are no longer of interest to people who are actually buying cars? Yes. I can't exactly see membership increasing in the Jowett Drivers Club. I've been saying this for years. Things go in phases, things go in cycles, and, you know, people are more interested in 1980s and 90s BMWs and Volvos than they are 50s and 60s cars, because they're easy to live with, and we're a different generation of people. For a little bit of context, 2006, £50,000 in 2006 is the same as about £80,000 today. And the average house price in 2006 was £173,000, whereas today it's £296,000. So if my maths is correct, the price of a house has gone up four times the price of inflation. Is that right? I think that's right. So let's dig straight into page one, where we immediately find Verdi Ferraris, and I have a 360 Modena, a 360 Spider on the top row, and a Testarossa. Now, the one that's going to grab us there is the Testarossa. There's a 1992 Testarossa with 12,000 miles at 39.5 grand. Okay, so even if we, okay, let's pretend it was 50 grand and that was £80,000 in today's money. Those Testarossas are now between 100 and 150. So you would have done very well buying your Testarossa into the 2006 at 39 grand. Interestingly, this page, we also have a Ferrari 550 Maranello at £71,000. Now that seems to have tracked pretty much at the rate of inflation. A 550 today, between £99,000 and £150,000, depending on the car and whatnot. But that car hasn't obviously changed too much. There's also a Porsche 996 Turbo on here. Now, that's a 2003 with 15,000 miles, so that would only be 3 years old at the time. But 60 grand then, these prices on these 996s have gone up and then they've kind of come back down a little bit. So I think that's probably about there or thereabouts. You'd probably get one for a little bit less than that today.
Okay, I've had to add in the edit process, I was way off on 996 turbo values. You can pick one up for about 35 grand on eBay if you have a look. So I think the prices have come way down and I haven't realised.
But they did go up a lot in the last couple of years and they've come back down. So interesting, straight in on the first page. Now, I'm going to do another follow-up video on page five, I think it is, because this Hawthorne's dealership page, I think is really interesting because I can see all the car number plates and I'm really curious to find out if these cars are still on the road. Now, the one I want to talk about is the BMW 3 Series in the middle, the 325 Sport Touring LG03 PDK. That car's still around. So here it is for sale, 57,000 miles and 15 grand. It looks like a lovely spec car. 325 Sport Touring Automatic Estate Orient Blue, Birchwood trim, sand beige leather. That seems pretty much exactly like the saloon that I had. That would be a lovely car. If you own that car, LG03 PDK, do get in touch. I'd love to hear from you. I checked the MOT history this morning. It is still on the road. It is MOT'd. I think it's on about 170,000 miles. So it's still out there. So if you know where that car is, get in touch, because it'd be really fun to make a video with you. Price-wise, at 15 grand, now that would have been an interesting thing to buy, because at £15,000, you could also have bought a Ferrari Mondial, or a Jaguar E-Type, or a Maserati Quattroporte Evolution 3.2 V8. Now, I love those cars. £12,950, 41,000 miles. Sound like an auctioneer then, don't I? But that looks to me like a lovely buy. It's also in green as well, which is rare. But it is funny as well, looking at this, this is autokinetic.co.uk. Looking at their page here, we've got a Mercedes S500 at £14,000, probably now worth about 25 pence. And one of my favourites, an E55 AMG Saloon. Here it is at 10 grand. Those came down a lot. You may have seen my video where I bought one for 2 grand, but they are now on the rise once more. Over here, we've got George Wise Motors. We have a Lamborghini Diablo, 1992, 67,000 kilometres, full service history with a new clutch, £39,000. How much would a Diablo be these days? I think they're 100 plus. I don't think you can buy a Diablo anymore for less than 100 grand. And George Wise has two more cars, another Testarossa, this time at £26,000. £26,000 for a Testarossa, which is the same as pretty much a Porsche 993 at the time. Maybe it's a bit leggy at 69,000 miles, but that is a Testarossa at Porsche 993 money, which incidentally is not a lot. George Wise also has a Ferrari 308 GTS Spider. Rosso Corsa over cream, obviously 28,000 miles at 24,995. 25 grand for a Ferrari 308. Now, it took a while for values on the 308 to really climb. They're there now. You know, you can't buy a 308 for less. Well, you can probably get one for just under 100 grand. But it's taken a while for those cars to climb. But doesn't that look like a bargain? In fact, all three of the Italian exotic cars from George Wise there, the Diablo, the Testarossa, and the 308 GTS, look like incredible bargains from the time. Yeah, absolutely. Should have bought those. Moving on, here we have a Jaguar XJ220. Now, just very quickly while I have a sip of tea, think how much an XJ220 is today in your head. Go on. Where are you at? How much do you think they are? I don't actually know. They're about 400 grand. I think they're about 400 grand now. This one here, it was supplied new by them originally. It's now sold here on 2,300 miles. It's an August 2000 car. Weren't they finished by 2000? But they did famously languish in showrooms because they couldn't sell the XJ220s. Very interesting story on that car. 2,300 miles, 135 grand. Well, that was a bargain. But again, it took a long time for the XJ220 to find its feet in terms of classic car values. Over at Austin Owen Elite Car Sales, we've got some interesting stuff. Here's one of mine. A 55 reg Mercedes-Benz S320 CDI. So that would be a year old, 13,000 miles, and that's £32,000. So you could have a Mercedes-Benz S320 CDI that was only a year old, or you could have a Ferrari Testarossa and £10,000 change. Sorry, £6,000 change. What would you rather go for? And then again, the Ferrari 355, £44,000 with 20,000 miles. That's pretty much tracked inflation. Again, taking a while for the 355 values to really take off. They've jumped in the last couple of years because with COVID, everything has jumped. But yeah, interesting. We also have a 2002 reg Audi TT. So that would have been 4 years old at the time. It's a convertible. 15 grand. So the same as a Ferrari Mondial, which is down here with Dunkel Hamilton at 16,995. Very interesting, isn't it, to see what has happened in the classic car market in the years since this magazine was printed. But it's also interesting to look at the cars that have just bombed or just not picked up. You know, you've got a Bentley Arnage. Here you go. Bentley Continental Le Mans Series LE. So 4 years old at the time, listed for 100 grand. Bentley prices are interesting because you can buy an Arnage these days for about £18,000. And yet in here, they were still commanding the big money. So if you'd bought an Arnage back in the day, huge loss. And then we're moving further on. We start to go in alphabetical order. Sadly, there's no Vs. There's not a single Volvo for sale in here. So, you know, people that don't know Volvos, you're all right. But I have got a Ford Sierra RS500 Cosworth. How much is this then? Place your bets now. It's an E-Reg, so it's a 1988. It doesn't list the mileage, but it says that it's immaculate, and that's £23,500. Now, I think that would have been on the high side of Sierra Cosworth values in 2006. But today, 100 grand, about 100 grand for an RS500. So you would have had a pretty good return on that if you bought that at the time. Not that that's why we do it. Obviously, you're watching Geoff Buys Cars. You know that we don't do it for the money. We basically do it for the fun. What else have we got? Let's flick on further through past all the Bentleys and Rolls Royces, because I'm really not interested. Going back to kind of what I said at the start of the video about different generations having different tastes. I mean, there's pages and pages here of Bentleys and Rolls Royces and stuff that I'm just really not bothered about. Interesting. A lot of Jags that were a lot of money, but we know that Jags bombed, and that's what makes them affordable and Geoff money today. I have a BMW 320 diesel on a 51 plate, so 4 years old, £9,000. So you're not a million miles away from Ferrari money on that 320 diesel SE auto. Or if you want a 325 SE Sport, well, that looks lovely. Topaz blue. £12,000 on 35,000 miles. That's a nice looking car. But it's just funny to see these when they were advertised, you know, at their original money. Right, specialist cars, GBs, a lifestyle defined. We've got a lot of Lamborghinis. We have a Rolls-Royce Phantom and a Mercedes McLaren SLR. £300,000 on the McLaren SLR. How much are those today? I'll have to have a look. I'll put it up here. I don't know. Would that have been a good buy? Not sure. I think they've come down a bit, but I might be wrong. And the Rolls-Royce Phantom at £240,000. Well, you'd have to be mad to have bought one of those, because that would have absolutely bombed. Lamborghini Gallardo's here at £130,000. They famously came down and have become almost affordable. Murcielago at £120,000, being 3 or 4 years old. And my favourite on this page is the Diablo SE30 at £100,000 with 25,000 miles on the clock. Would there have been much growth in that at £100,000? I'm not completely sure. I don't know where they're at today in terms of their values, but as I say, I'll put it all up here and you tell me what you think. Ferrari 612 Scaglietti F1 2006, brand new. Cost new, £210,000. For sale here by Specialist Cars GBs, £190,000. Why would you? It's literally the ugliest Ferrari that was ever made. Does nothing for me, and today you can buy one for that much. So I don't know whether you did well or not there. That'll do for that page, I think. There's a 348 Spider there at £27,000, which again looks like a bargain because they're £40,000 today, but then if you adjust that for inflation, that's there or thereabouts the same, isn't it? Are we getting flooded yet? I'm enjoying sitting and having a cup of tea with you. I hope you're enjoying sitting and having a cup of tea and a chat with me. Too much ranting, too much stress, too much editing, too much controversial issues. We'll just slow it down a bit for this video, haven't we? Just enjoy it. You probably do what I do. I watch people's videos whilst I'm doing the washing up, and I just have it on, and I'm sort of absorbing it, but at the same time, I'm also getting things done. Where do we go next? Try and remember what I highlighted next. Mercedes-Benz CL500 Coupe, 5 years old at the time. £21,000, reduced from £23,000. You can pick one of them up these days for very little money, so that represents a really good buy. Kind of touched on Porsche, so we're going to do that. This magazine has a massive section on American cars, which I find quite odd. I also found two Saabs as well. We've got a 2.2 linear estate with no price listed, and a 2.2 TDI 9.3 at £10,000. So you can have a Saab 9.3 2.2 diesel for £10,000. Or you could have, let's see if we can find something else that is ludicrously cheap at £10,000 to compare to our Saab. Cadillac Eldorado, anyone? 32 valve North Star, same money. They're probably about the same money today though, to be honest. A Saab 9.3 and a used Eldorado. I wouldn't want either of them, to be honest. I'm not a fan of the 9.3 so much as I am the 9.5. Can't find anything, so let's move on. We're now at Atlantic Sports Cars Limited, and they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 Dodge Vipers for sale. Dodge Viper is one of my all-time favourite cars, one of which is the early shape Viper RT10 at $27,995. I think they're 50 grand and more now, but you can't find them for sale very often. But it's just interesting that this magazine is primarily American stuff and Rolls-Royce and Bentleys. I find that quite funny. So let's skip on through all of the American stuff and the very old school advert for Pontins. There. That's pretty funny, isn't it? What is that? That is Saturday and Sunday. If you only go out once a year, then this night is for you. Pontins 2 Day of Rock and Roll, presented by Richie Gee. Just £20 and half price for under 16s. There you go. That's the way we used to live, kids. Getting into extreme power, the extreme power section. I have a Ford Escort RS Cosworth. No mileage listed, but at £15,800. Do you remember when Escort Cosworth bottomed out and you could pick one up for like 13 grand? This is around about that time. Getting on to some more interesting stuff here as well. Subaru Impreza P1 Coupe in Sonic Blue, 38,000 miles, £16,000. How much is a P1 today? Didn't one do 100 grand? I'm sure a P1 did 100 grand. Subaru Impreza Turbo RB5 in Steel Blue, lovely car, 12,500. You just can't find those for sale. They all got messed with, they all got modified, and they all got crashed. Now we're looking at Japanese and performance specialist cars on the South Coast. This one, there's no pictures, but you can scan through it. Mitsubishi Evo 8 GSR, 15 grand. 1995 Nissan Skyline GTR 2.6 twin turbo. Silver, standard car, 87,000 miles, 10,500. So you could have had the E46 Saloon for 12 grand. Or you could have saved yourself a bit of money and gone for a slightly older car and had a Nissan Skyline GTR 2.6. Should have done that. Mitsubishi Evo 6 in white, £10,500. Are they about three times that today? I think they are. We've got some Skyline GTSs and a Skyline GTST in white, £6,500. Not that many of those around. A Skyline 2.5 GTS Turbo, £5,500. Crikey, you're getting dangerously close to Geoff money there. More Skyline GTSs. No Nissan 200SXs. I really like those and they've completely gone missing. Here you go. A 2003 Ford KA 1.3 Style in bright red for £4,500. Or a Skyline GTS for £5,000. I'll take the Ford, please. Yeah, not really interested in Japanese cars. Lexus RX 300 at £18,000. Crikey, your money would have bombed on that one. And all of these big SUVs, your Mercedes MLs as well, they are now worth absolutely nothing. Back in 2006, we were still selling number plates for £99, your £99 bargain number plates from Speedy Reg. Yep, still a thing back then. And anything else to talk about? So that was a little whistle stop through an old magazine. I bought this specially on eBay just because I knew that this video would be a bit of fun. It wasn't perhaps the best magazine I could have bought. I'll do that again with another one. Tell me what kind of cars you want me to look at in future videos where I look at values and I'll have a little look. Again, too much American stuff in here. But there we go. After a few days of stress and stressful videos and being far too serious, a relaxed chat with Geoff Buys Cars. I also bought earlier on a 69 copper Camaro, just to cheer myself up. Do you want it? First person who gets to the end of the video and says, Geoff, I would have bought all those cars, which is also the code word for the video. Geoff, I would have bought all those cars. First person to type that in the comments and email me their address, geoffbuyscars@gmail.com, gets it in the post. I'll sign it as well, like a celebrity. Shall I do that? I'll sign it as well. There you go. Hope you enjoyed that little relaxed video with me. I'm getting steamed up now. Down by the river with Geoff Buys Cars. Was going to go out on my paddleboard today, but I missed my moment and then the rain came. What would you have bought? What was your favourite? In the comments, let me know which car would you have gone for out of all of those. I got to admit, just the Skyline. I really would have had the Skyline, or the RS500, or the Escort Cosworth, or some of the Ferraris. That was conclusive. River's almost at my back wheels. Do you want to see it? It's coming. The tide is indeed rising. Right, thank you very much for watching my video. And a full review on the Alfa Romeo and why I don't like it is coming soon.